right now. Only one pole. Got my cigarettes waterproof. And I made about 20 extra lures up, crankbaits and different soft plastics. About 20 different things, and put them in a waterproof box that you can buy. And my batteries and everything waterproof. And what I'm doing is wading way upriver, about a mile upstream, to explore a new area. So it's going to be very tedious, very hot, but I will be in the water. And it's just basically to find, there's a series of springs upriver that look really promising. So I'm trying to find them and just explore a new section of a familiar river that I've never been on. There's a 3 mile stretch of this river I've never fished. So it's hopefully gonna be a good day. It's basically just an experiment to see how well this place is. And I'm gonna be going after smallmouth, goggle eye, and pickerel is the main three species. Ooh, had one. Pretty nice bite there, whatever it was. Right after she pulled off. Imagine that. She sat here with me for 10 minutes. Not a bad guy, he's about a pound. She sat here for 10 minutes with me, and as soon as she drives away, it's when I catch my first fish. It's about a 3/4 pound smallmouth bass. Caught him on a 3-inch white Mr. Twister tail, the one with the black spots, 1/4 ounce plain jig head. On the edge of some lily pads where a spring comes in right behind me. This is one of the three springs I was telling you guys about. All right, it is 9 a.m. I should have came about 2 hours earlier, but it was hard to get ready this morning. So this is basically a place that says keep out, no park. It doesn't say no trespassing, but they don't want you people partying on this bridge and parking on it. So I figured, hey, I'll just have you drop me off then. As long as I stay in the river, I'm not doing anything illegal. So I just had her drop me off. It is a smallmouth, a small smallmouth, but it's a fish. That's fish number 2 already in 10 minutes. All right, little 1/4 pounder here. On the same lure, definitely a little guy. Tell you what, I already like the place though. Like I said before, I might not have mentioned it. I have a feeling this has very, if or little, fishing pressure because of the fact that you gotta get dropped off. I have a feeling that it don't get fished at all. So I should be able to get some true giants today, guys. And the good thing, that's more like it. I want to get a big old 18. I don't know. He's a decent, pretty one too. He's about 12 inches. That's small.
pretty colors on this guy. Very pretty. It's got very distinct dark brown lines. But I don't think I got to the magic spots yet. Yeah, when I do, I'll get some bigger fish. But it does have a good population so far. And that's what's important. Smallmouth, all right. All right, smallmouth number 6. No giants yet, but we'll get there. I can't even see my lure at all. It's that bad. I'm gonna have to bank. Oh yeah, I'm gonna have to go to the bank. He literally swallowed it so much I can't even see it. Oh my goodness. It's not a big one, but boy, he sure put up a fight. It's a pretty one. First cast on the contact swing impact swim bait. 1 ounce butterscotch jighead. Butterscotch and burrow. Butterscotch. far. But I have to admit, it's got good numbers. Kind of reminds me of the Gasconade River. You can go and catch 50 smallmouth in a day. And you do eventually get some bigger ones, but there's a lot of the average size. All right. I seen him chasing sunfish and feeding, or minnows, or whatever he was after. And I threw right over there, right in front of him. Knew exactly where he was. Largemouth, real largemouth. No spotted bass up this far. Good. At least not yet. I don't think there is, though. It's just too far upriver. Nice little largemouth. Alright. Nothing big yet, guys, but I'm definitely getting good numbers of 10 to 12 inch fish. He was sitting actually only about 8 inches of water. Little shaded area over there. Pretty cool. Another 11. The curse of the 11s again. Smallmouth number 9 or 10. Well, if nothing else, guys, I'm definitely getting the numbers today. At this rate, I'll get probably 30. That's number 11 right there. On fire with the pink and green, it looks like. One after another. Still using that pink and green twister tail. Quarter ounce butterscotch junior. 4 inches. river. What a beauty. I haven't caught one of these for years. A true hybrid bluegill. Nice. Thank you. another 11, bleeding a little bit. I made 18 smallmouth, just never gotten over one over 12, not a one. Learn this river, it's good for numbers. They tend to be generally smaller. And I'm kind of disappointed on the goggle eye too. I only caught one, and that was right by the bridge where I put in it. Just the one. Really thought there'd be a lot of them in here, but there's not.